If you've ever watched tennis or you've ever played it, you may have wondered, why is the tennis ball fuzzy? Why are tennis balls fuzzy? So why are tennis balls fuzzy?
No one's really asked me that question.
All right, because I got to ask you the same question I asked everybody else. Why are tennis balls fuzzy?
It's to slow them down.
Tennis balls are fuzzy because it cuts down on the aerodynamics of the ball. It
slows down the wind resistance.
It's something like the fuzz slows the ball down.
Yeah, it slows it.
You know, in today's time, since the rackets and the strings have become more powerful, they put a heavier felt on the ball to kind of slow things down.
See, the fuzziness makes it so they don't go through the air quite so fast. Otherwise, even the world's best players wouldn't be able to return a serve or something like that.
So one thing that everybody that I talked to said was that fuzz on a tennis ball was to slow it down. See, when a tennis ball hits a racket, it creates a lot of momentum, and an otherwise smooth ball would go really fast. But it's not just about speed, there's more to it than that. It's about control.
The tennis ball being fuzzy is how you control the speed.
Because they're easier to bounce off of. It's easier to make a bounce.
It also gives you more control over spin and things of that nature. So,
With the fuzz, it definitely, like, you can control the ball a lot more.
So speed and control. But there's more to it than that when it comes to the fuzz on a tennis ball. It's a little bit of history and it's a little bit of physics. So I went to the University of Tulsa to hang out with the tennis team and the physics department to find out the physics of the fuzz.
I think, first of all, it's fuzzy because just the origins of tennis back in the 16th and 17th century, when court tennis was first getting started, they would cover cork with cloth and wool and hair, and you don't want to mess with tradition, so it's maintained the fuzz even to today. But there's several performance reasons why you would prefer a fuzz on the ball. For instance, top athletes can hit the ball over 150 miles an hour on a service, and on a forehand they might hit it 70 to 80 miles an hour. That's coming so quickly, it's almost at the edge of athletes' ability to react to it. And so the hair actually can slow down the ball. It increases the drag, much in the same way that barnacles on a ship will slow the ship down. And so, you know, every good yachtsman knows that if you want to speed up the ship, you get the barnacles off the hull. In the same way, the fuzz will slow down the ball. And another thing too is that the fuzz will increase the effective spin. Tennis is a game of putting spin on the ball. That's due to a force called the Magnus effect.
The Magnus effect, or Magnus force, was named after German physicist H.G. Magnus. See, when a tennis ball spins, the fuzz on the ball catches air particles and creates a boundary layer around the ball.
Anytime a ball is rotating in an airstream, it kicks some of the air upward. And there's a basic law of physics that says, well, if that's going to happen, then the ball is going to have to move downward to compensate. So a tennis player that puts topspin on the ball will move down as a result. Or if they put backspin, it will tend to float, hang up in the air a little bit longer. So the presence of the fuzz will increase the effect of spin. But really, the only way you're going to know for sure is to actually get a tennis ball that doesn't have any fuzz on it. So I took a ball out of the same can as this one and with a belt sander just shaved off all the hair and then let tennis players play with it.
Well, playing with the rubber ball, which has no fuzz on it, the ball bounces a lot more. So if you put any amount of spin, the ball's going to bounce way higher than when the ball's fuzzy. So that makes it a lot harder to play. Also, without the fuzz, the ball's smaller in size and lighter. So when it's lighter, it has a tendency to fly easily. Like, you hit a ball, even if you hit it a little harder than the usual, it's just going to fly off the tennis court.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
Hit the ceiling?
Yeah, hit the ceiling, hit the fence, hit people, I don't know.
Now, one of the first things you notice is that it's much bouncier, it's harder to see, and when you play with it, it's just harder to adjust to it, harder to pick it up, harder to get it to spin the way you want.
Did you like the not fuzz? Was it fun or was it just frustrating because it was hard to control?
It was just different. I wouldn't say it was more fun or anything.
It wasn't comfortable though.
It's not comfortable,
wasn't
no.
Comfortable.
No, it wasn't comfortable.
No, I would hate playing with the ball which had no fuzz on it.
Yeah.
it would be horrible.
Okay. Now, when it comes to tennis, there's more factors about controlling a ball than just spin. There's different kinds of tennis courts. There's hard tennis courts like this one. There's clay courts and there's grass courts. And a tennis ball will react differently depending on the kind of court that you're on. So players have to adjust on how they control the ball depending on where they play.
So there's a number of performance reasons. You know, for instance, I didn't realize that that tennis balls come with different size fuzz on it depending on what altitude you're going to play at. If you're playing at a high altitude, then you need more fuzz on the ball to slow it down through that thinner air.
So that's some of the physics of why tennis balls are fuzzy. But why the yellow color?
Probably some horrifying experiment in the 1960s, I would imagine. Otherwise, I don't know.
That's awesome. Why yellow? Because it picks it, it's much easier to pick it up.
In the color spectrum, yellow is the easiest color for the human eye to see. And certain shades of yellow are so luminous that we can see them even in dark situations. And this is also the reason why a lot of modern day tennis courts are dark, is to contrast that yellow ball and to make it more visible and easier to follow. But it hasn't always been that way. See, before the 1960s and 70s, tennis balls were either white or black, depending on what kind of court you were playing on. But with the development of color cameras and broadcasting and recording these tennis events, but they realized that yellow was the most visible color that can be picked up by these cameras. So in 1972, the first yellow tennis ball was introduced, and we've been playing with them ever since.
So there's a number of performance reasons why you want fuzz on a tennis ball, but ultimately it goes back to that's the way they've always done it.
Tradition.
Yeah.
If you want to see another video about the Magnus effect, go and check out Veratasium's video here. So the next time you're playing tennis and you look at a ball and wonder why it's fuzzy, now you know why. So the first question is, why are tennis balls fuzzy with a helicopter noise in the background?
Well, tennis balls are fuzzy.